WA's health minister was forced to cancel his appointments today to hose down public anger over the condition of Princess Margaret Hospital. There are claims of overstretched staff working in third world conditions. Rebecca Munro is at PMH, where the minister today made an unscheduled visit. Rebecca.
Nerelda, Health Minister Kim Hames visited the hospital this afternoon, hitting back at claims that children with cancer are facing third world conditions in the oncology ward here. Although he has acknowledged there is a lack of resources and staff, he says it's still the best cancer treatment in the country, but that is little comfort for parents.
Four-year-old Archie Caldo was diagnosed with an aggressive form of cancer in March last year. He'll spend 8 months in Princess Margaret Hospital's oncology ward during his treatment. His parents, Richard and Claire, today defended the staff, but not the condition of the ward.
The ward itself is actually at breaking point. And the people responsible for making those decisions have to walk in our shoes.
Health Minister Kim Hames visited the ward today and admitted there is a lack of resources, basic furniture and equipment. He acknowledged staff shortages and that there's no space for families, but he maintains the quality of treatment is still the best in the country.
I was in Tanzania last year and you really get to see what third world services are like, and they're nothing like this.
You can be up to date with the best treatment in the world, but unless you have the staff to facilitate that, what's it worth?
The head of oncology at the hospital says her staff are feeling the pressure and don't have the time to support families the way they used to.
My staff have become increasingly stressed in the time that I've been doing this job.
The government says it will look into replacing equipment and has strategies in place to bring in more oncologists. But most of the problems won't be solved until the new hospital is built in 2015. Rick Parrish, whose son Elliot was treated until his death from a brain tumour 2 years ago, says the conditions escalate what is already a terrible time.
The machine's broken, or they don't have the right equipment, or, you know, a whole range of things. It just compounds the issue as a parent.
The Acting Director General of Health today met with Treasury to discuss more funding. Rebecca Munro, 10 News.